Howdy folks, my name is Jack and I'm building my own trading card sorting machine from the ground up, and that requires some highly specialized software. I know there are already a few great software solutions to visually recognize Magic cards, but I really don't want my project to rely on any outside entity for that. Also, it's a really interesting technical problem and I enjoy testing my skills. In this video, I'll be going over my software's planned feature scope as well as how I am prioritizing those features. I won't be going over any technical details, as that really should be a whole video on its own. First things first, it's important to define the overall goal of the software. It will need to receive a digital image, correctly identify the magic card within that image, and send commands to the machine such that that card is deposited into the correct pile. With that in mind, I'm going to start off by quickly going through a bunch of potential features. First up is normal card scanning. The software must be able to properly identify normal magic cards by name and set. This is kind of the entire point of the sorting machine. Custom sorting criteria. I apologize for the lack of clarity in my last video, but yes, you will be able to sort cards however you like. The machine will be able to accommodate at least a few of the most popular sorting methods. Upside down cards. Not every person keeps their stacks perfectly oriented. So there's a good chance cards that are being fed into the machine won't have uniform orientation. Luckily, this is an easy software fix. Unrecognized and backwards cards. If the scanned card is face down or otherwise cannot be recognized, the software should be able to detect an error and act accordingly. It's important that the software knows when it may be getting a card's ID wrong and deposits those errors into a dedicated error pile. International printings. Magic cards are printed in a few different languages, and it has been requested in my comments that the software be able to recognize not just English printings. Card condition scanning. A few people have requested functionality to measure a card's general condition as it goes through the machine. Another awesome feature would be to accurately detect whether or not a card is foiled. The machine should of course be able to handle foils, but this feature would be specifically to detect those foils. Confidence intervals. With most visual object recognition programs, the computer reports its best guess for the provided image along with its confidence in that guess. My program will naturally do the same, and users will be able to adjust at what confidence level cards are considered unrecognized. Pure cataloging. Sometimes, people don't want their cards rearranged. They just want a digital list of what they have. No physical sorting is required here. Digital inventory exporting. I do not intend to build a full inventory management application. Many exist already, and they are wonderful. My software simply needs to provide export options that are compatible with each of them. Full art and borderless cards. A few have mentioned that these increasingly popular printings occasionally pose issues for the current machines. That's an issue that I'd like my software not to have. Card shuffling. A few people have requested a shuffle feature. This would require no scanning, just pure redistribution from cards in the input stacks to piles at random. Pre-built reseller packs. Some resellers offer repacks of cards guaranteed to contain a certain type and quantity of each card. For them, it would be nice if the machine could assemble such packs to match their criteria. Mystery booster and the list. There are a few printed cards that look near identical, but are not. I'm not talking about core set reprints with similar set symbols. I'm talking specifically about cards from the list and mystery booster sets, for example. Telling these printings apart reliably and with speed will be a substantial challenge. Now let's get into how I'm prioritizing each of these features. First up, the entire point of the machine, really, is accurate normal card scanning. Within my normal designation here, I am including full art, borderless, and split style printings. The vast majority of cards will fall into this category. Next up are the export options. It's crucial that the machine integrates well with existing inventory management systems, so this is a must. Another must-have is custom sorting criteria. Everybody organizes their cards differently, and I want to provide a tool to help you sort your own way. Commonly used sorting criteria like market price, set, card name, and color are my top priorities, followed by more later. Moving on, we've got error handling and confidence intervals. These two go hand in hand, as both card guesses that don't meet the confidence threshold and otherwise unrecognizable cards will be deemed errors and deposited into the dedicated error pile. Upside down cards come next. It should be pretty easy to digitally write upside down cards for you hooligans out there with unorganized collections. Peer cataloging and shuffling both should be very easy software implementations, and I've seen them requested a few times, along with repacking. Recognizing near identical cards sadly will not be as easy. I plan on, at the very least, digitally flagging cards that could be identical printings until the recognition for them is fully flushed out. Next up on the priority list are international cards. Including support for the international pool adds a significant technical challenge, so this is not a feature I'm going to include at the start. Foil detection is also low on the priority list for me, as I'm sure it will prove to be a significant challenge to do well. I can again include a digital flag for scanned cards that may be foils. Last on my list here is card condition scanning. Not only is it a technical challenge to do well, but it's not a feature that I feel comfortable providing. A card's grade has a very direct impact on its value, and determining card value, sadly, is not the purpose of this machine. I should note that there are likely edge cases or other features that I forgot to mention here, but these are at least the big ones for me. Anyways, I hope this video provides some clarity on what to expect from the software side of things. I've been both overwhelmed and honored by all the support I've received for this project, so I can't thank you all enough for watching, and I sincerely hope that I can deliver on all that I'm planning here. My next video will either be diving into some more technical stuff on the software side, or taking a look at how the first prototype is coming along, so stay tuned either way. Thank you again for watching, and I'll see you next time!